Lawson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. This lesson is all about a set of skills that every pro guitar player uses, and when they do these ideas, their guitar parts jump out to really grab the listener's attention. So here on YouTube, I've got a collection of techniques that are all vital for you to learn about when it comes to using flashy attention-getting guitar sounds used by all of the pros. Then in the second half of this lesson on your Patreon video, I'll help you start applying these ideas across two application exercises. There's a riff with hammer-on pull-off legato lines combined with fret slides. Plus, I've also included a classical music style melody that has its focus on the application of scale sequencing. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection eBook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson eBook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. The sound that the world's greatest guitar players use time and time again tends to keep coming back to three popular techniques. We're going to learn all of them, starting with hammer-on and pull-off legato technique. Here's our first exercise. All right, so the first idea that I have for you is centered around this A minor chord. And it's more of a descending run. We're starting on second string, fifth and sixth frets. Hammer on, pull off, jump into the third string, doing a pull off 7 to 5. And on the fourth string, we've got a 7-5 pull off and coming back to the 7 with a hammer on one more time. So you do it nice and quick. It sounds really cool, very flashy. Now, if you're having some trouble with this on a clean channel sound, by all means, go and put on some distortion or overdrive on your amp, and it should help you a lot with the sustain to make it a little bit easier. Now, that's our descending concept there on that A minor, but I do have another one that's happening more on a C major sound, and it's up here off the sixth string. Now this one's a series of hammer-ons that are going through a major 7 arpeggio, starting on 6th string 7 to 8, and then on 5th string 7 to 10. Then we're moving to the 4th string going 9 and 10. On the 3rd string we're going to have a hammer-on pull-off going 9, 12, 9. And then we're going to return to 4th string. That's kind of like the turnaround part, that 9, 12, 9. We're going to do that and then return to the 4th string for a 10 to 9 pull off and just wrap it up with a 10 into a 9. That B note on the 9th fret 4th string is kind of like that major 7 effect, you know, so you're going to get a nice kind of dreamy sound on that last note. Sounds really cool. I'll play it a little slower for you. Very cool effect. So there's some hammer-on pull-off legato technique ideas you can start integrating in your playing. It's a really nice sound. Over on Patreon afterward for our part two video, I am going to be showing you a piece that's going to integrate these as well. But let's move on to our next idea. This is all about sequencing. I'll slow that a little bit down for you. It's a G major pentatonic sequenced. It's all triplets, it's eighth note triplets. So we're kind of like 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, just like that. So what I'm doing here is I'm using my first and third fingers. You probably noticed that I'm not really staying in position. I'm kind of drifting along. And it's because it makes it a little bit easier to execute the fingering technique for it. Especially when you speed it up and get it a little bit faster. But sequencing is a fantastic way to add a really flashy type of sound into your solo or a melodic line maybe you're putting into a piece. It's very mathematical. You know, we're setting up the scale in a way that we're sort of doing recurring orders of notes. and the sequence just basically applies those notes, taken in this case from a G major pentatonic scale, and it just, in this case, is again, it's just a traveling ascending along the fingerboard. Now, you can work these things out. There's tons of them in the creativeguitarstudio.com courses that I have, especially in the advanced guitar course of mine. There's a really good breakdown of sequencing when you first start into your full neck scale patterning work, and it's probably a must-use idea in the curriculum of mine, because I think it really helps get your scales 100% under your fingertips. But anyway, guys, I got one more of these for you. It's going to be based on some fret slides, and it goes like this. So that's our ascending. It's an A major sound. You can see there I'm starting on an A note at 5th fret. Really nice effect on that one. Check this out. Here's a descending line. So we're just starting from up high now. Targeting again to that A major sound. So let's break these things down for you. They're really nice, and you know, fret slides are a great way to travel way more laterally along the neck. It's a great way also to break out of a single position when you're doing something. If you're maybe just locked up doing way too much work within one area of the neck, you can really have a lot more flexibility of sound by traveling more linear now with this type of fret slide technique. And what we're doing here on the first one, the ascending one, we're taking 5th fret, sliding 7 to 9 on 6th string, grabbing 7 and 7 from 5th to 4th string, and then sliding 9 to 11 on 4th string. We're going to come up next into a lone note here on the 9th fret of 3rd string, and then slide forward here 10 to 12 on 2nd, grabbing a high 14 and then up to the high 12th fret on top. You can tell a really nice sound, and it travels along the neck laterally very quickly. You cover a lot of fretboard real estate that way. Let's go descending next. We're going to start on the 12th fret here, and we're on an E note in that case on 1st string. We're going to hit a 14th fret on the 2nd string. That's a C sharp, moving down to B and A. The B to A movement is a slide, 12th fret to 10th fret there. Then we're going to do another slide, F sharp, down into an E. That's 11th fret to 9th fret of 3rd string. You're going to need to jump back a little bit here to catch another 11 to 9 slide. And that's going to be going here from a C sharp down to a B note. And that's 11th fret to 9th fret on that 4th string, with an A note coming up next on 7th fret. To finish things off, we're going to do a slide from the 9th to 7th frets. That's a F sharp down to an E. And we're going to wrap everything up onto the A note. So as you can tell, we've got kind of a unique choice of notes from the A major scale here. But it sounds nice. It's all locked up 100% into our sound of A major. And now we've connected both, you know, ascending and descending, moving again, you can tell, very laterally along the guitar fingerboard with these fret slide techniques. Now, it's a great sound. You'll hear tons of professional guitar players use this. It doesn't matter who you want to point to, whether it's Jimmy Page, you know, Jimi Hendrix. If you want to look at, you know, Mark Knopfler, you could look at all the shredder guys like Satriani, Steve Vai, Tony McAlpine, you know, has got plenty of songs. I mean, the real neoclassical players, Yngwie Malmsteen. I mean, all the really, you know, shred neoclassical guys are going to use a lot of this sound because it is very classical music oriented. And by the way, in the part two video for this over on Patreon, I am going to have a classical style approach for this idea of sequencing for you. And it's going to be pretty cool. I'm also going to be getting into some cool combinations of the hammer-on pull off legato style concepts alongside of the fret sliding ideas as well. Now, one thing I want to make clear is I know we're breaking these apart into three separate concepts, but you can look at all of these as one package, really, and I think I'd like you to really try to do that as well. You know, you could do a hammer-on pull-off line, integrate some sequence runs, put in a fret slide concept in multi-position playing along the neck, and cover it all within one guitar solo, and it's not not like you have to do that. You don't have to include all these things in one solo, but it can be pretty nice to have mixes and matches of these different things across some melodic line that you're working on. So anyway, guys, I'm going to wrap up things here on YouTube right now. I look forward to catching up with you next over on Patreon, where we're going to have examples of these melodic examples used in some short pieces. There's going to be backing tracks that you're going to be able to get as well for download. And of course, all the other stuff that goes along with the Patreon handouts and everything like that. So I look forward to seeing you next on Patreon. Also keep in mind all the courses that I have available for you over on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in that bonus part two video, I'm going to help you to start applying all these ideas across two application exercises. There's a riff with hammer-on pull-off legato lines combined with fret slides, and I've also included a classical music style melody that focuses on the application of doing scale sequencing. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.